We want to review how to divide these numbers written in scientific notation on the TI84 graphing calculator. And then we'll write the result in both scientific notation as well as decimal notation. So it's a pretty straightforward process as long as we know how to type scientific notation into the graphing calculator. So for our numerator, we have 4.2 times 10 to the fourth. So we'll type in 4.2. And then we want this key here that has two capital E's in blue. So we'll press second comma. And now we just type in the exponent on 10. So we'll type in 4. So this is how we represent 4.2 times 10 to the fourth on this graphing calculator. And then we'll divide this by 8.4 times 10 to the negative 3. So we type in 8.4, second comma, negative 3. Be careful not to enter minus 3 or you will get an error. So our quotient is given here in decimal notation. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros. So we have 5 followed by 6 zeros, or 5 million. But now we also want to write this in scientific notation. Remember, in scientific notation, this number here has to be greater than or equal to 1 and less than 10. So if we write 5 million without the commas, it'll be helpful. The decimal's right here, but for scientific notation, it would have to be here. So we're going to have 5 times 10 raised to some power, and the power is determined by how many places we move the decimal. So we moved it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And that's going to be a positive 6. And the way I remember this is that when you multiply something by 10 to a positive power, this number is going to get larger. And we did start with a large number, so the exponent does have to be positive. Let's go and just try one more for practice. So our numerator is 6 times 10 to the negative 3. So we type in 6, second comma, negative 3. And we'll divide this by 3 times 10 to the second, entered as 3, second comma, 2. We don't want to use this e in our notation. This is going to be 2 times 10 to the negative 5 power. And now we also want to convert this to decimal notation this time. So if we use the number 2, where the decimal point is here, multiplying by 10 to a negative power is going to make this number smaller. So I know I have to move the decimal point left 5 places. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have to add 4 zeros here. So in decimal notation, we would have 0.00002, and often you'll see a 0 in the 1's place value. So this would be tenths, hundredths, thousandths, ten thousandths, hundred thousandths. This would be 2 hundred thousandths.